How's it going? Brian with Grand Roofing, and a quick tip for you because you, my friend, are looking and researching on can you roof over an existing layer of shingles, re-roof, whatever you want to call it, you found the right video because this may save you quite possibly hundreds or even a couple thousand dollars in damages. So I got one right here somebody attempted to do and they kind of botched it, or they were really trying to cut corners and they didn't simply add some flashing. So yes, if you're going to roof over, not if, I know you are, you're researching it, you're watching this video, so I know you, my friend, you're gonna do it. Do yourself a favor. Go out and find a few other little videos on how to simply reflash a chimney, reflash a pipe boot, reflash a wall, because what's gonna happen if you just simply roof over and you butt into corners and everywhere, or maybe you do that and you rely on caulking, you're gonna have water pour down areas like this, get in under your new layer of shingles. That's right, in between your new layer and your old layer, it's gonna get into the nails, rot it out. You're gonna have issues like this, maybe not this crazy custom fire escape in the attic. That's what we got right here. No, really what you got, PETA would love the hell out of this video because they are offering shelter to a four-legged little critter friend inside your attic. And guess what? There's now a Niagara Falls waterfall coming in right here, and it's falling down into that room right there. Yeah, yeah, we got drywall from the ceiling, key lapsed, we got water pouring through, we got green mold growing from the bottom and spores floating around in the air system. They're breathing it in. They're gonna turn into the Incredible Hulk. Who knows? I don't know. But if you are going to proceed in roofing over at your house, add you some flashing in your wall, add you a new pipe boot, or get this, save that pipe boot, save you a few bucks, and then you can go to Cheeseburger Land and get you a few of your favorite cheeseburgers. But all you gotta do, you take the bottom of the pipe boot loose, you tuck your new little shingle under, you lay it back down, shoot it off, and continue on your merry old way. That's all you gotta do. Same with pipe boots, box vents, chimney flashing, you name it, that's it. Walls, they're slightly different. You put a shingle down, you put a piece of step flash, you put the next shingle and another piece of step flash. By the way, step flashing, you get probably 20, 30 cents a piece, not very much, maybe 40 if you want them colored and painted and pretty, or go get your can of spray paint. Practice those graffiti skills you had slacked off on. Or maybe you're just really damn good at it. That's why you're trying to cut corners. Anyway, wow, I'm done. If you liked the video, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. I really don't care. Share this with your friends and family. If you know some way, not you, if you really, maybe I scared the hell out of you doing this. You're like, maybe I better just tear my roof off. That's really the best thing to do. But yeah, you can cut corners. Just don't cut them so much. You're going to have issues. Or Pete is going to be like, yeah, yeah, yeah. You're making nice little cozy little four-legged friend homes. Happy 2020.